In news overseas, China's foreign ministry urges the U.S. to stop politicizing chip export controls. That call comes following news Washington will take steps to prevent American chip makers from using loopholes in government curbs and selling AI chips to Beijing.
We believe that the U.S. should stop politicizing, instrumentalizing, and weaponizing special economic, trade, and technological issues, and stop disrupting the stability of the global production and supply chain. The Chinese side will closely follow relevant developments and resolutely safeguard its own rights and interests.
The new rules expected this week will add to the already sweeping U.S. restrictions on shipments of advanced chips and chip-making equipment to China. Chip stocks fell on the news. TSMC, the world-leading contract chip maker, on Monday warned the company's dominance is under threat from geopolitical and economic challenges, with the industry turning into a strategic battleground.
Asian markets ended Monday trade in a sea of red. Aside from the possible escalation of violence in the Middle East, investors this week are also bracing for Japan's inflation data and China's third quarter GDP report. The Nikkei 225 led losses in the region, tumbling 2%. Here at home, Philippine shares joined the rout, with the main index slumping more than 1%.
The recent dip really presented opportunities to come to the market. We had a support of 6,000 tested, and it actually bounced back from that. Good news is that we're above the 5.7 from last year, so that's already a kind of a higher trend, an uptrend that we're kind of forming. But if I look at the longer term picture, I think what this could be telling us is we might be climbing a wall of worry where, you know, growth is actually good, and yet we're kind of dampened with inflation, dampened with having to deal with interest rates that are reining in growth along with inflation. So for us, it's medium-term optimistic. On the short term, you may want to go for, you know, safe haven assets like bonds and also REITs or dividend issuing stocks.
The Marcos administration planning to boost the use of electric vehicles in the country. Speaking at the launch of Chinese automotive brand Dongfeng in the Philippines, President Marcos said the move is in line with government's bid to lessen carbon emissions and the country's dependence on imported fuel. Marcos also urged the private sector to invest in manufacturing facilities, citing fiscal incentives for EVs.
In the Philippines, the transportation sector is the largest source of energy-related greenhouse gas emissions. So, if we aim to fulfill our pledge to the Paris Agreement, we need to boost the share of electric vehicles in the total projected vehicle fleet nationwide. The government aims to increase the share of electric vehicles to 10%, or hopefully 50% by 2040. As of late 2020, there are just around 8,800 electric vehicles in the country.
And here are some stocks to watch out for. Monitoring shares of drug retailer Rite Aid, which filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy on Sunday, a move that would halt lawsuits over its alleged role in the U.S. opioid crisis. Rite Aid shares will kick off trading at 65 cents apiece. Also in focus, shares of Manchester United, which fell sharply following reports that the Qatari group led by Sheikh Tahseem has withdrawn its bid for the Premier League Titan. Shares of Manchester United are down nearly 11% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Pfizer and its German partner BioNTech. BioNTech on Monday warned of write-offs of up to 900 million euros or $947 million amid a plunge in the use of pandemic-related products. That comes on the heels of Pfizer's warning last Friday, which had prompted the U.S. drug maker to slash its full-year guidance. BioNTech stock tumbled 6% in pre-market trading, while Pfizer is down 2.5%.